Parashat Bo. Be'etzem hayom hazeh yatzu kol tzivot Hashem eretz Mitzrayim. In the essence of the day, all of the armies of Israel went out. Hine amru hazal al chana. Our sages taught us about chana. Miyom shebara HaKadosh Baruch Hu et olamo lo haya adam shekaro HaKadosh Baruch Hu tzevakot ad shebara chana. Nobody called the God of hosts God till Chana. Dehainu, Shei patra tchila likrot HaKadosh Baruch Hu aveket tzevakot. She was the first one to say the God of hosts, to call him that way. Ve'amar HaKadosh Baruch Hu, and God answered her and said, Atid, in the future, Ben Shelach, your child, your son, will as well start this prophecy with this name of God. Liftoah benvuah b'shem ze. Kmo shekatuv ayomer Shmuel, as it says in Shmuel, the prophet said, Ko amar Hashem tzefakot pakadti. Here, the God of hosts said, I remembered. Ve'anevim acharonim, and the later prophets, Chagi, Zechariah, Malachi, more than anybody, more than others, use this name of God. V'kaimalan, d'tzevakot u'mishiv'a shemot she'enam milchakim. We find that this word, this name of Hashem, Tzevaot, Hashem Tzevakot, like we say, Adonai Tzevaot imanu misgav lanu le'akov sela, this name is one of the seven names of God which cannot be erased, which means it's a holy name. Ve'ine mitchila, to understand why does this name, how does this name become such an important name? Yesh lehagdim inyan hashemot mahu. What is this whole concept that God has a name? God has different names. Gam ma'alat shem ha-miyuchad shem ha-vayi al shar ha-shemot, and as well, the name of God which we're used to saying in the blessings, Amonai. What is the special quality that this name has over all the other names? Ve'achar kach yitbaer im yirtzeh Hashem shem tzevakot. And afterwards we will explain the name of God which is tzevakot. Hine yadua. It is known. Shema'uto ve'atzmuto shel ha'ensof. The essence of the infinite one who pashut betachrit apshitut is in a perfect purity and a perfect level of simplicity. There is no combination. Everything is pure and simple. Velo shayach klal b'mauto ve'atzmuto inyan ha'toharim shenimtzeu shekino lo yitbarach b'torah o b'divrei ha'nevi'im o divrei chazal. And really, names have no connection to God. Names are titles, and God is much above all types of titles. Kumo chacham, for example, sage, hasid, kind, rahman, merciful, chulu. Ve'kayotze ba'en. Ki hu yitbarach meromam ve'nizgav u'muvdal mikol gdarim elu, because God is separated and absolutely above all these types of titles. Shachochma. Shehi ha'ma'ala rishona banivraim minechshevet ke'asi ha'gashmit legabe ma'oto ve'atzmuto. For God, wisdom, which is certainly the highest possible human quality, the first of all qualities, for God, action, which is the lowest, and wisdom, which is the highest, is all at the same level. U'mikol sheken p'chinat amidot, how much more so when we qualify God by any type of character trait. Kema'amar delav mikol ilen midot ihu klal kenudaz. Eliyahu Navi, Elijah the prophet, teaches us that God is above all types of titles and character traits and characteristics or names. Ve'afal pichen yesh metziut inyan ha-toharim halalu sheba'u betanach u'bedivrei chazal. Nevertheless, we see that there are names of God which are very specific that we use. De'ainu al derech ma'amar chazal b'makom she'ata motze gdulato sham ata motze anvat nuto. Because our sages teach us that really where you see the greatness of God, you find the greatness of God in His humility. What does that mean? Shehu yitbarach mashpil et atzmo liot mitlabesh beser kelim de atzilut shen prinat chesed u'gvura. God is ready, even though He's above all these names, to actually lower His presence and unify Himself with the vessels of the world of emanation, the world of Atzilut, and actually become one with these names and titles. V'gimel rishonot chokhmah bina da'at, as well with the levels of wisdom, understanding, and da'at, connection, and focus. Ve'az shayach likoto betoarim, shenikra chacham mitzad labshuto bechokhmah. At this moment, that He is unified with the vessel, with the channel He chose to act through, He can be called by that channel. Ukemamar Eliyahu antu Hakim, as Elijah the prophet said, you are wise. You have wisdom. You are wise. What does it mean? Perush shemesaper beandvatnuto shemashpil et atzmo litlabesh bebchinat kli hachokhma. It's the praise of God that God, you're so great that you're ready to actually lower yourself even to the level of wisdom in order to be able to interact, because an infinite God, in order for Him to interact with a world, with an existence which is external to Him, which is part of Him and external to Him in comparison to His levels, which is nothing before Him. This shows the humility of God. This is of the great praises of God. When you have, for example, imagine a person which is the president of a great company, and he is going to take the time to take care of something which is not of his level at all. At that moment, it shows his greatness. I'll tell you a story. My great friend, Rabbi Wilhelm, which is the rabbi of Thailand, he gets 200,000 visitors a year. About 300 visitors a day, minimum. And he told me, Rabbi, you know what happens? Someone knocks at the door of the Chabad house, and he speaks to the secretary. He says, I need to speak to the rabbi. I need to speak to the rabbi. It's very important. And he goes to speak to the rabbi and says, Rabbi, do you know where I can buy cheap shirts here in Thailand? And the rabbi, with humility, tells him, go to this store or that store. It's really not the level of the rabbi to deal with such things. The level of the rabbi is to teach Torah. Right? Lav ucha de malka leishtashea be mile de idiota. Even for God to create this world, it's not of His level. Nevertheless, God gives us the opportunity through all these names to be able to connect to Him. So when you connect to the name of God, you're really connecting to the essence of Hashem. But recognize that this is just like a tzaddik nistar, just like a tzaddik which is a hidden tzaddik. He might look like you and me, just like a rebbe. He might look like you and me, dress like you and me, but really his level of connection has nothing to do with this material world. Even though wisdom for him is a low thing, he's much higher than wisdom, and we can't understand and comprehend this. V'chen mashpil et atzmo litlabesh beprinat chesed, v'nikra az agadol uchasid. And God will lower Himself to do kindness with us. Even though He could have intermediaries, but He does that kindness with us through the vessel of kindness. And at that moment, we call Him great, or we call Him Hasid, kind. V'zehu shagdula I anvatnuto, she'al yedei anava v'ashpala she'ishpil et atzmo litlabesh b'midat ha'chesed, az daika shayach mikroto gadol, ma she'en ken ma'uto v'atzmuto merumam megeder hanal, kanal. So basically, when God encloses himself in a specific aspect, that's when you can call him of these different names. But otherwise, God is much higher than this. The beauty is that in the world of Atzilut, in the world of emanation, God unifies himself to such a degree that you don't see the vessel, you see the light, you understand that the light and the vessel is one. You don't see the light, you just see the way God becomes one with his quality. And that was till the prophets. At the time of the prophets, they were able to bring down Hashem's name to a level that through the prophets, the words of the prophets would actually be the word of God, as if it's his essence speaking, so to say, and have the same effect that it had when we were of a higher level. So God lowered himself and became Hashem Tzevakot. That will be all for today. God bless you.